Alrighty, so today at PowerJack Repair we got ASUS Q301L for the power jack repair. I see a missing screw right here. Meaning somebody already tried to open it up. I'm gonna test and see if it's really that bad. Alright, so here we can see that the minus is conducting the electricity just fine. We can wiggle that the minus is just fine, and the plus doesn't show us anything, so the plus is the problem. Alright, so let's take all the screws out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, 10. Maybe there are screws under the pads here. Let me see first. And there's nothing. Maybe here. Nope, nothing. So don't take the pads out. So those are the shorter screws, and we need a different bit because this is much finer bit than needed here. So I'm gonna put it right there. Let's find the proper bit. Nope. Nope. Oh yeah. So this screw right here, those two screws are the longest screws. Short, long, long, long. So those two are the longest. All right. Separating them. Okay. Here we see that something is broken at the hinge right here, because the hinge is iffy. There are messed up plastic pieces, so that's probably the reason why the jack broke in the first place. So before we're gonna touch anything, we have to disconnect the battery right here. Right here is the battery. So disconnect that. Like that. Then we wanna remove the battery because there is the battery is overlapping this board. And then this board overlaps the that board. Okay. So here. Let's see. Alright, just had another package delivered. So. Okay. Alright, so the battery is out. Now we need to disconnect the this wire. So what you do is you just flip the white tab upwards, remove the wire. Flip the black tab upwards, remove the wire. Flip this wire upwards, this one, remove the wire. Okay. Lots of loose plastic pieces. You wanna shake some of this stuff out. There's a screw immediately fell out of here. You wanna get all the garbage out. Okay, so here we need to disconnect this wire right here. Like that and like that. So this wire is disconnected. Now we got one, two, three, four right there. And here we got the black wire is the black, white is the white. There are two indications right here. So disconnect the black, disconnect the white. Make sure you guide it outwards like that. Alright, so now what you want to do is you're ready to pull out the hard drive, right? Yeah. Alright, so hard drive gets pulled. Here we got another wire. It should flip out and disconnect. Here we got three screws right here that hold the small motherboard in place if you want to disconnect. Alright, so that's gonna go here. And that's gonna go right there. Okay. Alright, okay. And we got three screws right here. One, two, three. And we got one more right there for the hinge. Can't really do anything here for some reason. Well, no problem. Let's disconnect the tab for the LCD cable. Like that, and like that. So now we can. Yeah, the hinge is kind of hard. So what you want to do, you probably want to rotate that screw right there so that the hinge will be much less. I mean, this hinge seems to be fine on the left side. This hinge seems to be fine. That hinge is really hard to move in and out. So let's see if you can adjust the screw. You probably can, I just want to remove the motherboard first. And then we got one screw right here. Let's see if we can just take everything out. Yep. So we took it out, and doesn't seem like the jack is faulty in any way. Well, we'll disconnect it and see what the problem is. But I want to adjust the screw first, because it's probably going to be broken again in no time. And here I can see that this thing doesn't hold anything anymore. Anyways, let's see if which way is this screw gonna be loosened up. Let's see if we can just. Okay. Screw. It's pretty hard on there. Right. All So hopefully I just don't want to break the part that's mounted to the inside of the screen, but it doesn't want to turn well on this particular model. It's so tight. Let me see if I can do something with those guys. Can't get to it from this end. No, hold on. The hinge is broken here as well, so it's no big deal. Let's try and take this out. Alright. Oh wow. It's going harder on this one. Yeah. So we got the bit called 5.5, and we want to rotate it slightly. Getting there. One more turn. Okay. Beautiful. That's the way I like it. Nice. So right now both hinges are not as hard to rotate and they won't be breaking. Like in this case, it broke off the plastic casing. Usually they broke off on the screen itself. And it's much more painful repair procedure if that happens. So what I want to do, I want to remove this excess broken stuff, and I'm gonna fix it once I fix the jack on the motherboard. But basically the reason your jack breaks is probably because of the screens being too tight. Okay, so drain out of that. Alrighty. Wonderful. Okay. So now we have both hinges. This one is a lot easier to rotate, but this one doesn't have this screw right here, the main screw. So it's gonna be holding mostly on this side. Not so much holding, but when your screen is open, you don't want it to just fall or like flip down. You still want some resistance. So most of the resistance is still gonna be on this hinge. But this hinge, because this highest leverage screw is not here, it needs a lot more freedom. So that's that. Right. So here we got the motherboard. Motherboard looks alright. I will inspect why it doesn't conduct the electricity the way it's supposed to conduct. Let's see. So this should have the power. Yep, that's negative. And nothing on the positive. Let's trace it to the positive. Yep, nothing coming out of the back leg. So for some reason, my understanding, the connection is broken inside of the jack someplace. So you see absolutely nothing coming out. It should be showing something like that, but it's not showing anything. So let's desolder this connector and solder the new one in. And before we're gonna start any sort of soldering, what we wanna do is, well, this is pretty easy. Let's see. This is called Captain Tape. It prevents any nearby components from being damaged while I'm soldering. So VGA port is extremely hard to fix, usually not fixable. So we wanna insulate the Captain. Then let's take the smaller Captain tape and insulate the rest of it. I don't want the nearby components to be So we're recording here. Yeah, we're recording. Let's see. Okay. Wonderful. All right. So let's switch to the soldering station. Fire up the light. Fire up the exhaust. Figure out the focus here so that you would be able to see what I'm doing. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add a little bit more solder to the joints. And then desolder the connector from the motherboard.
Okay, so we can see that the rear pin is loose and free. Meaning the pin itself broke. You see how it's sticking out? So if you press on it, it's gonna go back in. Okay, it's gonna pull through. Let's try and get everything else out. What we do is like that. Like that. Lower it down a little bit. remove the old jack, just the new jack. And the problem was the rear of the pin fell off, not fell off, but broke basically inside of the jack.
Did get the jack replaced. The problem was in fact the jack itself, the pin inside of the jack broke off. What you want to do now, you want to clean it a little bit right here. Clean the chemicals off the board. So let's continue here. Just making sure that none of the nearby components got damaged. Yep, nothing, everything looks fine. And like that. Good job. So you see, like brand new soldering. Alrighty, so we're not done yet because the hinges are not gonna hold by itself because this part right here is broken and that part right there is missing altogether. So what we need to do something about that. And well, I know what I'm gonna do, so no big deal. Let's put it all back together. Wanna see if it's dusty on the heatsink. No, the heatsink is pretty clean. That one's kinda dusty, but the heatsink is clean. Let's see. Understanding the tape on the bottom holds it all together, which I don't want to be touching, but yeah. Still get into it. I don't want to be 100% sure that it's all nice and clean. Yeah, it's all clean. I'm just gonna says dust right here, some dust right there, and some dust right there. Okay. I got plenty of tape, so it wasn't that big of a deal. Let's mount it the way it's supposed to be mounted, like that, and like that. Okay. Now we wanna have the plug right here plugged in. Okay, we want to connect this touchpad. We want to connect this keyboard cable like that. Connect the this board cable. Now what you need to do is find this guy, the hard drive caddy cable, board, like that, and like that. Strange. Right, my guess, you need to attach this board before you're gonna put the main board in. That with the clip gonna be clicking perfectly in. Okay. Now the lights on the front. And now you have the hard drive, which you wanna insert into this plug right here. Okay, let's keep it in place. Pads are going bad on the hard drive, so the hard drive is gonna crash eventually. Alright, here we got. Those are the shortest screws possible. Good job. Now let's connect the battery in here, like that, and the battery screws. Alrighty, now the part, the main part we need to do is we need to make sure that everything's going to be holding down just fine with the hinges, because of the hinges and all that. So you want to remove all of the loose components everywhere, all of the loose plastics. Here I probably need to insulate this power button because I know what I'm gonna do, and it doesn't involve this button getting messed up. So let's see. Wanna just get to see how everything gonna be aligned. So we put this right here like that, and so we gonna have this screw right here, that screw right there, that's still good. One screw right here, which is okay, and that's the and the second screw right here, which is good. So all right, so I don't want this hinge to be locked in place. I mean, I want it to be locked in place, but I don't want it to be locked in place the way I'm gonna be doing it. All right, so yeah. First thing I want to do, I want to connect this cable, because what I'm going to do next is going to change the way how I wouldn't be able to connect the cable after I'm done with it. So, okay, so how would I like to do it? Okay, this one is pretty straightforward. So I'm locking it in place like that. Let's secure it with the two bolts right now. Maybe one bolt, okay, so the one that's holding the power. So that's okay. This one is probably gonna be the same way, like that, right? Now it's nice and easy when it's rotating back and forth. So I wanted to secure it right here first. Okay, so make sure it's nice and straight. Secure this guy as well. Just don't go all the way around, because the nut on the inside doesn't hold well. So use that. Okay, so now this is all secured. Okay, that's all connected. You want to connect the wireless cables like that and like that. Make sure they are out of the way like that. Wonderful, good job. There are two ways to fix this thing. First is put a whole bunch of cement right here. Now cement gonna take 24 hours to cure. The second way is to use hot glue, and I'm thinking that's the right thing to do, because this is a top end, and on the top end we need, if you're gonna be sandwich, if you're gonna make a sandwich out of it, the glue gonna be much better filler as a sandwich with the top cover. So the goal is to put the glue right here, and then put the cover on top really fast, so that the glue will be sandwiched with the top cover, in between the top cover. So yeah, that's the goal. Let's get the glue gun. Power it up. Now, since I'm gonna be putting the another broken plastic. Okay, since I'm gonna be putting the cover back on, now is a good time to connect the battery, because once the cover is on, I will not be able to connect the battery. But the important part is not to touch any metal parts while the glue gun is being employed here. So I want to see if there's any loose parts on this end. Nope. Okay, so let me just clean it a little bit here. Okay, how's the glue gun doing? It's cast down pretty fast, okay. Now I probably want to start with filling out this hole. Come on. Still working. You know what, because it smells a bit, I'm gonna move to the southern station. Southern station. Thank you. good job here. Good job. Now what we want to do is we want to connect those two. This is right here. Sure that everything is clamped together, and we need to set the glue a little bit so it would settle, and so this is garbage, this screw. Added a few more screws. And we're good, right? Alright, so if you want to watch a little bit more, I really need the glue to dry up because it's still kind of not dry. I hope nothing leaked through. So on this end, I can see the glue went through right here, and this end. Bit more than I wanted to, but it's all good. Now the glue is an insulator and still hot. I can still feel it being nice and warm right here. So I'm gonna let it dry a few more minutes. Let me test the power supply now. The best thing to do is just cement. We usually let dry cement for about 24 hours. The glue settles pretty quick, maybe like 20-30 minutes. So okay. So the power supply, I can test the power supply. The power supply seems to be alright. Now the thing to keep in mind is there are two pins inside of the barrel. Once those pins go towards the back, that means they are not gonna grab onto the pin the jack as much as if they are towards the front. So this is the reason why the jack breaks, because the plug is a bit too big. The leverage from the plug basically breaks the connector inside. Another thing is this is supposed to be 65 watt and they use a 90 watt adapter. So this is a 90 watt adapter, this is a 65 watt laptop. The more power you give it, the more chances the pin gonna break. So the best thing to do for this laptop is to buy another cheap Chinese power supply off of eBay for about $7-$8, because Chinese power supplies have really soft tips. And they don't break the jack as much. This is still Chinese, but this is like $60-$70 adapter, which is swappable tips. And the more swappable tips you got, the worse chances for your power supply the more chances that your laptop gonna break, the power jack gonna break. Okay, so I can feel the heat going away. Can't really keep you much longer. I see that the glue is still. Yeah, the glue hasn't settled yet. Yeah, I would like to give it just a few more minutes. Okay. Well, again, because it's on camera, let's open it up slowly. And it opens up easily, but the screen still stays, as you can see. It doesn't just flip out and breaks out. So the hinges right there are not gonna break on the laptop. All right, so the good thing, we got the light in the front right here. In the front, right there. All right, right here. Right here. That's when we connect it. So if we disconnect it, the light goes away. If we connect the plug, the light's supposed to come up. Yep, it does come up. And now we power up the system. And we got Asus right there. So the system does work. So there's no tricks, like we did something and it didn't work. So again, we are at powercheckrepair.net. If in Chicago, stop by. The repair should take exactly an hour. We charge $100 total for the labor parts and shipping back to you. $60 if you just bring us the motherboard, if you send us the motherboard. So I don't want to show the private information here on the screen. I just want to double check the touchpad, the keyboard, and charge it up a little bit and send it on its way. So, come on. All right. The keyboard worked, the touchpad works, and the battery. Okay. The battery. The battery is charging. I just wanted to show you that the battery is charging here. It shouldn't be charging. It's not anyway. Guys, if it's not too much trouble, leave a like on this video, comment if you have any questions. Here. I want to show you that it's plugged in and charging, so here. Shoot. 1 second, please. 1 minute. It's gonna restart and it's gonna show us that it's everything charging. Yeah, I mean, the hinge repair is no extra charge, obviously. It's not really a big deal. It makes updating right now. All right, guys, let's not make this video any longer. The point is, it does work. Everything does work, and by the time the update is gonna kick in, it's gonna take forever. Thank you so much for watching. Garbage goes to garbage. And yeah, thank you. Bye.